what has four legs, a tail, and is green or red in the middle? Stay tuned and we'll give you that answer when we come back. Welcome to another edition of Laurel Focus. I'm Karen Kobeck, reporting for Laurel TV. The answer to my riddle is, of course, none other than a Fidos for Freedom companion. I recently had the pleasure of visiting their facility on Sandy Spring Road and was able to witness firsthand how this wonderful volunteer organization brings hope and freedom to a lot of people through assistance dogs. So why don't I let this great group of people tell you in their own words what Fidos for Freedom does for many in the Laurel area.
I'm Tracy Bowman, and I am the president of the board of directors here at Fidos for Freedom. We are located in Laurel, Maryland, and we are assistance and therapy dog organization. We've been in Laurel since 1987, and we train assistance dogs to help people with disabilities or hearing loss to help mitigate the impacts of their disability. We also have a therapy dog, such as this little dog here, Nutmeg. And we go to nursing homes, hospitals, visit people in healthcare facilities just to brighten their day and make that experience a little bit easier, a little bit brighter. What we need is funding, of course. Funding. Money drives mission. And so we are an all-volunteer organization here. We survive on the generosity of the public to make all this happen. When our clients get their dog, they pay us a small fee, but it doesn't cover the costs of raising and training these dogs. So that's about $2,500 a year. So the generosity of the public is just so important to us. Other than that, we can always use volunteers. It takes a lot of different things to run an organization such as this. We have a part-time bookkeeper, a part-time office manager, and a part-time janitor. Other than that, everything that we do here is done by volunteers. So please, if you have a special skill or talent, then please come on by, join us. We'd love to have you.
Demonstrate something else as well. As if you're walking down the street and you drop your keys, you'll hear your keys hit the ground, but a person that's deaf or hard of hearing may not, and they may just keep on going and get to their car if they're in a park going to a parking lot and find out that they no longer have their keys and they have no idea where they left, where they fell. But if you have a service or hearing dog with you, the hearing dog is taught to pick up the keys so that you won't lose them when they hit the ground.
This is Tank. I'm Cara. This is Tank, my mobility service dog. And Tank helps me pick up things if I drop them. He helps me to remove clothing, remove my shoes, things like that. So I'll have him demonstrate taking off my shoe and sock.
Thank you. Look at that. Very good. And I think Abby's trainers are sitting over there with a big smile on their face. Thank you, Sandy and Kona. The other things our dogs do is open doors, whether it be the push button type that they can jump up and put their paw on it, or they can open a door. A lot of our doors have these type of handles on it in our homes, and we tie these poles to it so the dogs can close, help their partner close the door, especially if it's a heavy door. Come here, baby. Started doing this,